Hi everyone. Thanks for coming. Thanks for coming to my session. It's short to use the functions. I'm taking care of half of business development and ads administration. I know it's hard to do because not very often ads administration injected into business development. I would say maybe we're the only one who has this structure. Anyway, let me quickly go through the agenda today. So today we are discussing. We're going to talk about Nexton, so just a few words maybe on who we are. Most probably, most of you know us, but those who don't know me, I would say the words. Words as well, a key title, I would say the key two titles, because we have here, of course, Ona and UAC. And then we'll talk a bit more for the administration and partnership, like what are the trends, where is it going to. What are the projections and plans for the upcoming 5 years? And then once we take the conclusion that we do need actually the health position in our tactics, it's a question mark, then basically I will talk a bit more on what exactly we are doing, what exactly we're suggesting to do in terms of monetization strategy for future generation. And then basically a bit of a deep dive, some like hundreds of slides, and it's just been short to that in terms of our examples of what have we done recently, and how did it work to basically boost our revenue in terms of fast evolution. And just a small bonus at the end, we stay until the end, maybe just a one slide bonus to share also some examples from our guests. Okay. So, it's just an intro from my side. Business development and administration, this is how I see it, because sometimes people ask, what do you do? I'm doing business development and administration. Like, what the hell? It's just a few words. It happened historically, I would say, that administration was not a big part of our company. I wouldn't say it's the right way or path to move, but this is what it is. So basically, we moved to the structure, and it's working now. So we don't want basically to shift so far. We don't want to shift to another structure, to structure it differently. We need to separate, I would say, department in the company, because there's a golden rule: don't touch something that is working. So yeah. Then who we are, who is Nexton, what is the hero? So we are a public company traded on Nasdaq. We have a headquarters here in Cyprus. We have also offices in Armenia, Kazakhstan, and people spreading all over the world. We have around 700 plus employees, and basically we are now in the top 5 publishers in Europe. So in terms of InnoWars, our key title, we have about 200 million installs globally since we launched the game. This is basically the statistics for our two games, which is mobile and web. Our key markets for us are USA, Germany, and Japan, which represents around 60% of our total players and basically revenue. And then we have so basically the player itself, our blue bike, it's named Man, 30 plus in terms of age. And then in terms of downloads, yeah, it's 200 million downloads worldwide. So yeah, just a few words about Nexton, about the Hero Wars. And go to the next slide. Can you switch to the next slide, please? You will sell with the digital search. Sorry, it's here. Okay, thanks a lot. So here's the statistics Columbia Awards in the US last year. We were actually number two for Virginia, sure. It's not all the gaming apps. So we were number two in terms of downloads back on the on-premise channel, Starlight only. And then in terms of top grossing, we were number seven for the past year. But this is not including the ad spend. How many of you do know that out of these 10 titles, how many titles have ad spend decision? Just a guess.
One.
I mean, exactly, of course. Anyone else? All of them. Actually not. Actually only three titles. It's number three, which is the Dragon Ball version of Dragon Ball, and then it's number eight, Summoner's War. And the Awards. So basically, it's not, I would say, a common strategy for a PGG. There are pros and cons for sure. I will talk more about the pros. Cons is, I would say, specific title. So basically, they differ from title to title. But maybe I will talk about the pros and cons for making the ad presentation to the game work. Yeah, so basically, the next chapter will be about what is coming next in terms of plans and in terms of structure of ads market in this channel. Next slide, please. Just a question to you. Do you know, or what do you think about introducing ads in your media campaign? Is it, do you really need it or not? That's the question also to the audience. Okay. You can answer. Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay, I wouldn't expect this answer, but anyway, most people, because I'm talking to publishers, as well, or the top 10 grossing chart as well, guys from Summoner's War, from Ray, from Lyle, most of them, they're not so sure as you are. Actually, they are quite resistant in terms of reproduction gaps in the game. First of all, why? Because it wasn't started from the beginning. So they started the game only with in-apps, and now it's really hard to, you know, inject ads in the game because you need to redo your UI links, you need to redo your economics in the game. A lot of things, you know, to work on, and basically you need to basically pursue your product team to inject your ads in the game, and it's very difficult. I would say it's the hardest part, basically, to make sure product teams are on your side in terms of injecting ads in the game. And this is the way we come to the ads in the game. It was back in 2017, if I'm not mistaken, or 18. It was long ago, it was a long process, but anyway, this is the question everybody needs to ask to themselves and to their product teams as well. So I was on this Google Meetup, I think it was in Ireland last year in October, and there were interesting statistics about how basically the games and the apps will develop in the coming 5 to 10 years. This is a projection to 2030. So here are interesting statistics about time spent in the games. So basically, the more user spends, or the more players spend time in the game, the more he can interact with ads. This is quite obvious, but not everybody thinks about it. Everybody thinks that, I will increase the prices, or I will have more in-app options, or I will have live ops. But then there is a limit of money that people tend to spend in the game. So if you increase the time players spend in the game, like from 30 minutes, let's say, to 2 hours, it doesn't mean that they will increase twice their spend in terms of in-apps. But what they definitely can do is to increase the time spent in ads. So basically, this is my guess. I would say it's not something we can solve. You can debate this, but then I think in terms of time spent in games, if it is increasing and Google is projecting it's going to be increased by 2030, then definitely people will spend more time in ads in game. Next slide, please. Next slide. Oh, yeah, okay. And this is also from this meetup with Google. They were showing interesting statistics in terms of split of revenue coming from in-apps and ads. So this is not specifically related to RNG. There wasn't any statistics specifically related to RNG. But then it's interesting to see that, for example, in 2020, when COVID started, people jumped into the mobile games and you see the increase of in-app share in the games and apps worldwide, so across all the genres, across all the apps. But then you see the projection that basically by 2027, the share of advertising or ads revenue will increase to 67%, which is basically their height. This is what they Google will be projecting how the market or how the share of how the split between in-apps and ads will develop by 2027. Now, that's the direction, I would say. It doesn't mean that it should be 67%, it could be 65%, but the direction we see that Google is projecting the growth of ads revenue and the decrease of in-app revenue in the coming years. It's also interesting to understand and to digest within your team, within your company, in terms of like where do you move. Do you need to still ads in the game, or do you need to delay ads in the game, or do you use waiting for a couple of years and then not be ahead of the market, to be lagging or behind the market? It's just a question mark too. Okay, so now what do we do in terms of ads in the games, and specifically for RPG, because we are an expert, we're working in the major RPG genre. Yes, we have also farming and adventure game, but this is a separate stuff. We can speak about it later. Next slide. So, it actually depends highly on your strategy, whether you need which formats basically to integrate in the game. I would say for RPG, what is mainly working is you want the video and the overall design. Why is that? Because the audience in the game is quite hardcore audience, hardcore players. They play a lot. They like gameplay. They play for a couple of years. So we have players that play for 3 or 4 years already in our game. And they don't want to be disturbed by some ads like interstitial, spawners, sort of all the formats, like magic formats. They feel it like disturbing, and they feel the experience of the game is lacking, I would say, if we introduce some other formats like emotive video or war on the wall. Why is that? Because emotive video on the wall, it is the placements that people tend to launch themselves. So basically, if they want to progress in the game, then they really watch your video or all. So this is where this is basically the tests we've done for the past 5 years. Now, it doesn't mean that you shouldn't segment your players or try and test whether you need to put interstitials in the game, for example, for non-payers. And it could be one of the tests you could do, but this is also quite tricky. You need to monitor your community, you need to monitor your players' feedback, whether it's, the membership feedback is growing or not, so it's also quite tricky. But in terms of the videos and the wall, there is almost no negative effect due to why guys use this helpful stuff in the game. Some negative feedback in terms of how does it work, but that's a separate stuff. That's what you need to remember the back end to make sure everything is working perfectly and correctly. Just maybe next slide. So these are just an examples I'm showing here in terms of where we integrated exactly the important videos in number one. It is, I would say, tested maybe many times or hundreds of times in terms of how does it look, what's the cooldown, what's the number of ads players can watch during the displacement. And yeah, basically, UI UX but also tested a lot, so that's a big work behind what you see on screen. Okay. Okay. So this, as I said, this is just an example in terms of how does it work. But on the right hand side, you see the soft currency that people can get in the game nowadays. And why it is important to put the button to watch the ad in exactly the same way, because people tend to lack of the currency, for example, hard currency, the gems you see on the screen. And instantly they see that they can get this soft currency in terms of the gems, but also using the ads. And this is where we see the jump in terms of engagement. So basically, if you look at the ad somewhere in the UI, which is not so. Which is not so close to launching the screen, then you will see a huge decline in terms of engagement, because people tend to have interest only like a few seconds when they need basically the cards. So it's just, you know, a few small examples in terms of like what have we done in UI UX testing and working on the implementation of ads in the game. And this is basically how we integrated the overhaul. So we have the overhaul exactly integrated in the AI where you can buy the currency, so you can buy the currency for real money, and then basically you will see the placement to earn the barrels for free just through requests. So this is the overhaul itself. Now coming to the next placement, this is basically the placement where people can launch also kind of quests in the game, and basically you can launch quests for free. Some of the quests are available just for the currency itself, and they can launch the quest using the ad spot. So it should be pretty quick. So the message here again should be really quick, and it should be available in the same UI UX as people tend to play. It should be hidden somewhere. Now, once you decide basically to integrate ads to the game, what do you do? Hiring a team. This is basically what we faced recently. We are still facing the lack of resources. So before 2023, I would say there were only one employee who was basically doing ads monetization. That again is specifically dedicated to ads monetization. Now we're moving to this structure, like slightly moving, or slowly moving, I would say. It's not like we have this structure right now in place, but this is where I want to move in terms of forming the ads monetization department. Hiring a team, training your team, you need definitely to have somebody from the product specifically dedicated for ads monetization, because what we see now, the bottleneck is not on the back end or not on the ads monetization side, that is on the product ends. So in terms of QA and product, there is a bottleneck because people are responsible for in-apps, and they see mainly their effort or income coming from in-apps. They don't have resources to work on ads, and this is our problem, because all our tasks are coming through product, and all our tasks are coming through QA, game designers, and they need to book these resources, so it's quite difficult. So all you need to do is to hire your dedicated team for ads monetization if you want to do this problem. So if you want just to test a few things, definitely not, but then if you want to make it like significant part of your revenue, then definitely you need a team. Now, just a few examples on what have we done recently, just that was what happened recently to Bruce Bremen in the presentation. For HaloWorks Alliance, so this is specifically for our mobile version, because we have HaloWorks Dominion app, which is the web version of the game. Not version, but it's actually exactly the same game. This is a revenue coming from in-apps and ads. Basically, in the gray line, you will see the revenue coming from in-apps. And you will see the structure, you will see the significant part coming from ads as well. And this basically can help sometimes to substitute some of the revenue lacking from in-apps. For example, your light bulbs didn't come well, or you tested some new in-apps and it's not working well. And then your ads revenue can come on top and basically substitute this revenue or can help you get to the plan here. If you have plans, if you have revenue for a month, quarter, etc. So your ads revenue can help you reach this plan, because sometimes it's moving in different directions. For example, in-apps are dropping, ads revenue either still growing. So we saw this, for example, for previous year for April, which is on the next slide. This is a graph showing only ads revenue per company. So you see that starting from February, March, and April, we saw a huge jump in ads revenue. This is where we started to test interesting stuff, which is called geo-multipliers offer wall. And our revenue basically jumped like 100%, so basically it's increased twice from what it was in the past before the February 2020. And then we saw a little bit of decline in apps. It's not because of the overall sales increase in any way. So we could cover those decline with this ads revenue and with a double the ads revenue because of our experiments and because of our tests and push for ads revenue. Now, what we've done as well is testing the second offer. That's not the common thing I would say for advertisers. Only I would say for maybe casual or hybrid casual sometimes. We've tested the second offer wall and the complete debate in terms of whether we can need a second offer wall or doesn't need. But anyway, we saw a 15% of additional revenue coming. For sure, there is some decline in the first offer wall, but then when we A/B test, by the way, we A/B test everything, so it's not like we just, put the idea into the game and it's in the we see some increase and all. We A/B test, quite a lot, and then we do a long A/B test on the step where it's working on the long projections, not only in the short term. And then we saw an increase of 15% of revenue coming from introduction of the second level module. That's also an example. Now, to wrap up, and one slide, as I promised from the beginning, these are the five, I would say, key points which were written into our, that's why you see it. For us, so it's coming from our experience, it's coming from what we face, the problems and issues in the company, not only for HaloWorks, but also for our second titles, which is the second title, which is that office. So you need to experiment a lot. You need to understand that it's not like you have an idea, you put this idea, you see the increase in revenue, and you just sit back, relax, drinking your champagne, and that's it. No, you need to experiment every day, every month. To test new things, you need to test new UX, you need to test new placements, you need to test new words. So there's a lot of stuff to do with the ads monetization, even if it's RPG, because some people think that RPG are lagging behind the casual hybrid casual games. Yes, at some point that's true, but then it doesn't mean you don't need to test. So test a lot, this is what we face. At some point of time, the stuff or I would say we increased the number of tests, and almost at the same time we saw a decline in terms of revenue for ads. Then make sure you have the right placements for ads. That's quite obvious for them. We had a lot of experiments where we placed the ads in the wrong placement, and we don't see an uplift in terms of revenue. And then once we change the placement to basically have a bit more convenient for people to click on ad or to what they needed actually ad, we see a huge jump in terms of information training and in terms of revenue. So basically you need to carefully test and understand where do you place your ad. You can download the rewards and see the placements and the rewards and the demo if you wish. What do you need to do as well? You need to check your back end of that implementation. I know it's also sound quite obvious, but we came to this also with some mistakes, and we came to this with some problems. So for example, if you're not updating your app as TXT file, or if you're not updating your SDKs, if you're not updating your adapters, it could highly impact your revenue up to 20%. So at some point of time, we were updating the app as TXT file, and we saw a jump in terms of like almost 20% of the revenue. Updated this ads. So do look into your backend of ad monetization. You need to get, we need to hire a good specialist who has an experience in ad monetization. This is also what we came to. Just by seeing this problem and by understanding that we need to. So nobody told us that we need to do this. It wasn't so obvious, I would say. Then the fourth one, make sure the ads you integrate again correlate to the content values. Because what do ads you create to the game as well, like for example, we are blocking any ads that contains drugs, politics, alcohol, drugs, religion. So we block all this stuff just for the beginning. Why? Because there are some disturbing ads from players. There were some negative feedback as well from my players, the good guys. This is what example of playing in the game, watching this ad in your game. So we're blocking this from the beginning, and as well we're using the ad quality tool of iron source mitigation, which is really helpful, which basically helps us block specific creatives and specific publishers after the complaints of the players. So it's really working. Yeah. What you can do, you can block ads for a specific network, just from the beginning. And then you can watch, you can use this ad quality tool, you can watch all the creatives, you can watch like every publisher that shows ads in your name. And you can block that at the creative publisher using this tool. Actually, not using this tool, but you can ask a specific network to block this publisher or this creative from showing it to you. And the fifth one is actually coming out of the fourth one, address your player complaints. What we faced from the beginning was we introduced the ads, there were a lot of complaints from the players. This ad is not working, this ad is not being poor, this ad is not showing the bad ads, this ad crashes the app. You do need to have a team, or you do need to have a dedicated person, the developer in this ad, who will be actually managing this, who will be fixing this in the game. In terms of if the ad is crashing the game, this is a bad experience. This is not something you wish, even if it's premium or bringing you some additional revenue, this is a It's not the experience that you wish your players would have, so they should enjoy the game. This is comes first, and then getting additional revenue. This is comes second. So basically, you need to have a specific guy or team who is responsible for player complaints and fixing these complaints straightforward, quite quickly. This is by the way what we're facing now, and still facing, I would say, we didn't solve it for 100% yet. There are some blocking points for this, but you need to work on this, you need to dedicate somebody who can work on this. This is pretty important. So this is just maybe a few things that I didn't mention that we are working now on. I would say those tasks will be in a couple of months, so maybe now we are in a group. Definitely we will test cooldowns, different cooldowns, because as it's a evolving market. So it doesn't mean that you, for example, 1 year ago you tested a cooldown of 8 hours, and now it's the right cooldown for the game. You should test a lot. First of all, you should test cooldowns, maybe lower cooldowns, maybe longer cooldowns, but this is what we want to test in coming months. Now, rewards, this is very tricky because this affects your economy. But then, what we also noticed that if the reward is not interesting for the player, at some point they will stop watching the ad because they reach some level of the game where the reward is like not worth even, you know, pressing the button and spending 30 seconds on the ad. So you do need to work very cautiously with the rewards, so it's not affecting your game economy, which by the way happens to your website board. And you do at the same time need players to engage with ads. And by the way, the more player gets days in the game, especially as related to players, the more they pay in the game, the bigger piece you get in the game. This is also true. That is why you need to work very hard in rewards to make this balance or to find this right balance. Then in terms of integrating ads and making the rewards less, this is we haven't done in the past, and this is I think the main traditional engagement rate for players, because yes, the placements are quite visible now, they're quite quite easily reachable. But then some players, they don't even go to all these placements. What do we want to do is we want to add ads in their rewards and their requests. So they will need to make some quests to get a reward, and that one of the quests would be, for example, watch 5 ads or do the overhaul. So get a reward from the overhaul. And basically what we've noticed as well, that the users are quite resistant to the overhaul because they're afraid of the overhaul, they don't know what is the overhaul. Nobody explains it. What's the overhaul. So what do we want to do? We want to make kind of a soft tutorial for them, so that it explains the gradually growing their interest to the overhaul. And now coming to bullets, I know maybe it's not interesting to everyone, but we've tested the rewarded videos, we've tested the overhaul for our web game, and it's kind of very difficult because the ad market, you will not see mediation at zero, and you will not see a lot of networks on the market for web. It's really difficult to find the right partner first. And it's really difficult to get the level of eCPMs at least, you know, 5 times lower compared to mobile. So it's also difficult to justify why we need this cheap ads in the game for web. But then we've tested rewarded videos, and this is what I said. This is what I said on the previous slide. The rewards were too high, and we saw a decline in terms of in-app purchases. So we did the A/B test, and we understand at that point of time that it's not working for web. We need to find the right balance. Unfortunately, we didn't have a team dedicated specifically, a product team dedicated specifically for this. That is why we were able to stop completely with the videos. And now the game doesn't contain any more videos, but we do soaring up if you took the overall revenue, having the overall uplift in-house and ads revenue. So that is why keeping the overall for web is working. It is needed to be any works, and it needed constantly to be updated in terms of UI, UX. A lot of things need to be done. But then we do see that it's working for us, and I think we will be moving to the direction. We'll be testing other partners, we'll be testing other replacements for web, because the user behavior for web is different compared to mobile business. Now this was the last slide. Thank you very much for your attention. If you have any questions, you can ask me now or maybe.
Some beautiful slides, a lot of things from the world. What do you think about advertising?
Sorry?
What do you think about advertising?
No ads. This is an interesting tool, basically, to those placements that are not initiated by the user. So if you have, for example, a decision, then for sure you can have a button to make the booking decisions for $1 or even $2. But we so far have only those placements that are initiated specifically by user. So they are not disturbing, like, to some extent, they are not disturbing the experience of the player. So that is why we didn't think about this user. I don't think, to be honest, it will be it will bring us additional revenue for this game, but definitely for those games that are using placements other than important videos and overall, it could be the case to test it also again.
Does
Google
not
Exactly. You are basically straight to the point. I also noticed that I would catch your attention by moving in a different direction and basically injecting more in ads, so they see an increase in terms of in ad revenue. Now, I don't want to say that we are moving to the direction that we want to increase ad revenue. What we want to do is basically to make this experience more fun and more interesting to the player, so more players can play the game. Because now you all know that the percentage of the players out of the total traffic is quite low. So non-payers have to turn the game 1 week, 2 week, maximum, I would say 30 days, they will turn the game if they, you know, cannot progress in the game properly. And without ads, this will be quite difficult, and also without ads, you cannot monetize those players that are not paying anything. So this is, I would say, interesting direction for RPGs, I would say, who were, for the past years, who were mainly directed to in-apps only, and those players who were not paying in the game, they were just, you know, full of waves. So if you're not paying, it's fine, it's simple for us, you can beat the game, you can download that game. No, what we're saying, every player is important for us, even those that are not paying in the game. So you can stay and you can play the game and you can progress in the game, maybe not as quickly, but definitely not as quickly compared to those who are paying. But for sure, you can progress in the game. So I was playing myself in Hero Wars using only ads. It's a bit of it's a bit of a challenge, but still you can play the game. So if you wish, if you like the game, you can play the game using only ads. Thank you so much.